Chinese party, Chinese party. That's the way to learn Chinese. Chinese party, Chinese party. That's the way to learn Chinese. 你好, this is Chinese Pod. I'm Jenny.
Hey, and I'm John, and we have an elementary lesson today.
Yes, now I think this situation is quite particular to China, where people often travel by bus, and the buses are always super crowded.
Right, and this is a very civilized lesson, right?
是的, because it's about giving up your seat to someone who might need it more.
Okay, so if you do that, then of course you'll leave a very good impression on the Chinese people.
对的。那 how do we say to give up your seat?
I should be asking you that.
让座,让座。
Okay, that's two fourth tones, right?
是的,让座。那座 means seat.
Right, and then 让 means something like to let or to yield.
对。
So to yield a seat.
Why does that sound quite funny to me?
Can we hear it again?
让座,让座。
Okay, so now we're going to listen to the dialogue three times and you will hear that phrase.
对话第一遍。
妈妈,快到了吗?
还有三站。
哦。妈妈,一位老爷爷上来了。我给他让座好吗?
好，
爷爷，您坐这儿。
不用，小朋友，你坐。
爷爷，您坐。
真是个好孩子，谢谢你。
第二遍。
妈妈，快到了吗？
还有三站。
哦，妈妈。一位老爷爷上来了，我给他让座好吗？
好，
爷爷，您坐这儿。
不用，小朋友，你坐。
爷爷，您坐。
真是个好孩子，谢谢你。
第三遍。
妈妈。快到了吗？
还有三站。
哦。妈妈，一位老爷爷上来了，我给他让座好吗？
好。
爷爷，您坐这儿。
不用，小朋友，你坐。
爷爷，您坐。
真是个好孩子，谢谢你。
Okay, it's time to translate the dialogue. So if you missed anything, worry not.
妈妈,快到了吗?
Mom, are we almost there?
妈妈,快到了吗?
Mommy, are we almost there?
妈妈,快到了吗?
还有三站。
There are still three stops.
还有三站。
There are still three more stops.
还有三站。哦,妈妈,一位老爷爷上来了。
Oh, mom, an old man got on.
哦,妈妈,一位老爷爷上来了。
Oh, mommy, an old man got on.
哦,妈妈,一位老爷爷上来了。我给他让座好吗?
I'll give him my seat, okay?
我给他让座好吗?
I'll give my seat to him, okay?
我给他让座好吗?好。
Okay.
好。
Okay.
好。爷爷,您坐这儿。
Grandpa, you sit here.
爷爷,您坐这儿。
Sir, please sit here.
爷爷,您坐这儿。不用,小朋友,你坐。
No need, child, you sit.
不用,小朋友,你坐。
No need, child, you sit.
不用,小朋友,你坐。爷爷,您坐。
Grandpa, you sit.
爷爷,您坐。
Sir, please sit.
爷爷,您坐。 真是个好孩子，谢谢你。
You're such a good kid. Thank you.
真是个好孩子，谢谢你。
You really are a good kid. Thank you.
真是个好孩子，谢谢你。Well, John, do you know in China when we were kids, we were taught or told to 让座
to give up your seat to whom?
To old people or pregnant women.
Ah, okay. Mm.
So anyway, it's a sign of being a good, well-behaved kid.
Okay. Mm. I think that's true for many countries. Mm. All right, let's go through this dialogue line by line, and we'll talk about some of the other cultural issues a little bit later.
好,now starting at the very top, we have a very useful pattern. 快到了吗?快到了吗?
Right, okay, so 到 means to arrive.
对。
And then 快到了 means to arrive soon.
对的,快到了。So, now I find I use this a lot when...I know I'm running late, but I'm trying to reassure my friend who's waiting for me that I'll be there very soon. 我快到了。
So you maybe make a phone call and you tell them,
快到了,快到了。
I'm almost there.
嗯,
okay, yeah, super useful.
对,快到了吗?快到了吗?
快到了。
Oh, now, in the dialogue, they still have three stops to go. So the mom says, 还有三站,还有三站。
Okay, so 还有, literally, still there is, right?
嗯，对。
So that's 还, second tone,
yep.
And 有, third tone, meaning there is.
Yes.
There are.
Ah.
And so there are still...
三站,三站。
Okay, so 三 meaning three, of course, and what's the deal with 站?
Oh, 站, 第四声, it means a stop, refers to a bus stop, a subway stop.
Okay, literally it means stand, right?
嗯，对。
But it's the same as stop in English.
对的。
Okay, so that's fourth tone, right?
嗯，站，还有三站。
Okay, so you're definitely going to hear that word anytime you're talking about bus stops or subway stops.
嗯，是的。And then there is an old man getting on the bus.
The plot thickens.
是的。Now, how did the kid say that?
Yeah, an old man. The kid said...
一位老爷爷。一位老爷爷。
Okay, so 老爷爷 means old grandpa, right?
嗯，是的。But it doesn't have to be your blood relative.
Okay, it's kind of a polite term for an older man.
对对，老爷爷。
So 老, third tone, and 爷爷, second tone and neutral tone, right?
对。And the kid also uses the measure word 喂，一位，一位老爷爷。
Okay, so that would be the same as 一个, but with more respect.
对的。
So 一位老爷爷。So if the kid said 一个老爷爷, would that be wrong?
It's not wrong, but it's more respectful. It's more polite to use 喂. And I think after kids start to go to kindergarten, so after they received some schooling, the teacher really hones it in them that you should use 喂 with old people.
Okay, so they're just used to hearing it that way and they'll naturally say it that way.
对,一位老爷爷。
Greetings everyone and welcome to Chinese Pod Trivia. Our first question is, how long will it take you to become an intermediate Chinese speaker using the Chinese Pod app? Is it A, the rest of your life? B, you should already be an intermediate speaker? C, 3 months? Or D, Chinese Pod has an app?
You should already be in...
Ooh, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, 3 months. That's right. Head over to ChinesePod.com now to register for your access to over 4,000 lessons.Get the Chinese Pod app now on Google Play or the App Store.
Okay, so what does the old man do?
他上来了。上来了。
Okay, so 上, that's the verb you use to get on a train, to get on a bus.
对。上来了。
Okay, and because they're already on the bus, and he's getting on, he's coming towards them, so you just add this 来, 上来。
对。一位老爷爷上来了。
Okay, so he's gotten on the bus where we are.
对的。And then the kid suggests, maybe I should give him my seat. 我给他让座。我给他让座。
Okay, so 让座, that's the verb meaning to give up a seat.
对。
And it's preceded by
他，我给他让座。
So to him, give up my seat.
对的，我给他让座。
Okay, and then the kid asks the mother, 好吗? Is that like for permission or why is the kid asking that?
Well, kids in China are told to be very obedient. So, when they want to do something, when they have thoughts of their own, their instinct is, maybe I should ask my parents.
Okay.
So, I think it's quite a cultural thing. 好吗?妈妈好吗?
So, this kid is super good, huh?
很乖的。
Okay, very good kid.
我小时候, when I was a kid, 就是这样。
you were this way.
对,
yeah,
对,
I believe it. Okay, so what does the child say to the old man?
他说, 爷爷, 您坐这儿, 您坐这儿。
Okay, so the kid can address the old man as 爷爷, and that's not strange.
不奇怪, 不 strange.
It's friendly.
Yes, and that's how younger people address older people in general.
Okay. And then the kid shows even more respect by saying 您 instead of just 你.
你对那您 N-I-N, second tone is 你 is you, but it's the respectful way to say it.
Okay, again, the kid being super polite. You sit here.
对
There's no please in here, but the whole tone of the sentence is very polite, right?
Yes, exactly. 您坐这儿. But then the 爷爷 refuses the offer. 他说不用。小朋友你坐不用小朋友你坐
Okay, now 用 is a verb which means to use, but when you see 不用 that means no need.
Yes.
Okay, so remember that as a phrase, 不用 means no need to do something.
不用小朋友你坐小朋友你坐
Okay, now 小朋友 it looks like little friend, but it actually just means kid.
Kids.对
right?
小朋友
So he's not actually saying little friend, he's saying kid
对小朋友、Now it's a cultural thing to reject a kind offer. And that's what you're expected to do in China、
Just like when someone offers you tea、
你说不用不用
Because 、yeah, you're so polite
对 But then of course、it's understood that he will eventually take the seat
Okay, you just have to persist.
是的。
If you're nice enough to give up your seat, you have to put in the extra effort to persist.
对。好, it's a very cute little dialogue, and it also reveals some cultural peculiarities.
Okay, so let's listen to that three more times, and then we have a few other things to say.
对话第一遍。
妈妈。快到了吗？
还有三站。
哦，
妈妈，一位老爷爷上来了，我给他让座好吗？
好。
爷爷，您坐这儿。
不用，小朋友，你坐。
爷爷，您坐。
真是个好孩子，谢谢你。
第二遍，
妈妈，快到了吗？
还有三站。
哦，
妈妈，一位老爷爷上来了，我给他让座好吗？
好。
爷爷，您坐这儿。
不用，小朋友，你坐。
爷爷，您坐。
真是个好孩子。谢谢你。
第三遍，
妈妈，快到了吗？
还有三站。
哦，
妈妈，一位老爷爷上来了，我给他让座好吗？
好。
爷爷，您坐这儿。
不用，小朋友，你坐。
爷爷，您坐。
真是个好孩子，谢谢你。
All right, so Jenny, speaking of 让座, I have a few of my own experiences about this in China I'd like to share.
那你给别人让座吗?
Yeah, I have, but actually one time it was a bit frustrating because I tried to give my seat to an older person, and they were polite. They're like, no, no, no. And they kept refusing, but I was already standing up. Meanwhile, someone else stole my seat.
Ah, 真的? How old was the person?
Just fairly young, 20s.
Oh, I have just one phrase for him or her. Do you remember man or woman?
Man.
One phrase for him.
What?
不要脸. Shameless.
He doesn't want face.
对啊,
Shameless.
不可以这样.
Yeah, and another thing is, I used to ride the bus frequently in Hangzhou. And people would 让座 to me all the time.
Oh, 因为你是外国朋友.
Yeah, they're just being super polite. Even old people.
Oh, 真的?
And that's super embarrassing, because I have to be like, no, no, please. You sit, you're old, I'm healthy.
你看,中国人,我们很 hospitable.
Yeah, but I didn't know. Was I being rude by not taking the seat? But they're old. What do you think?
I don't think you're being rude. I don't think they would think you're rude.
If I took the seat.
对。What they want you to do is to have a super nice impression of China and the Chinese people. And you probably would have.
But I was in such a moral dilemma. All right, well, anyway, please let us know if this works out for you, this whole 让座 thing. And if you have any stories or questions, please come to ChinesePod.com.
And of course, you can practice the language with one of our ChinesePod teachers. That's it for today. 再见。
再见。
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.ChinesePod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number 1394. So just go to www.ChinesePod.com/1394 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.ChinesePod.com/1394.